The idea of making an Indian curry in the West is to just dump everything in a pot, add spices, and voila, you can now eat it with your naan bread. Programming equivalent of that would be to have a make curry function that calls switch on heat, dump stuff, switch off heat. But programmers are a lot smarter than that. That's why they invented curring functions in programming. In curring, you break a complex function down into a chain of functions to build up the final result step by step. Allow me to show you the beautiful world of curring with the help of examples. Let's do this. Just like how the term curry in Indian curry doesn't come from India, the term curry in curring functions also has its origin in the West. Haskell Curry was a famous American mathematician and logician. His work on lambda calculus laid the foundation of functional programming. If his name sounds familiar, that's because he has a whole programming language called Haskell named after him. Now here is something interesting about the programming language Haskell. A function in Haskell cannot take more than one argument. Can you even imagine that? How would you write a multiply function that simply multiplies two numbers by taking just one of the numbers as argument? Seems impossible, right? That's where curring comes in. For a simple multiplication function, you can call it with arguments 2 and 5, and it would simply return you 10 as the answer. Curring functions are slightly different. When curring, you nest functions inside another function. Let me show you the curried version of this multiply function. Curry multiply takes number 1 as argument. Please note that it takes only one argument like we discussed earlier. Within this curry multiply function, we define an inner nested function that takes number 2 as argument and multiplies it with number 1. Curry multiply simply returns this inner function. This might look a little confusing the first time, but let's try this function out. Let's call the curry multiply with number 1 as 2. This would return a function that takes number 2 as input and simply multiplies it by 2, or in other words, doubles it. So we call this function double. Now you simply double 5 and you will get 10 as the result. So we have achieved the same result as before, but with curring this time. One might say that this is cool and all, but what's the real world application of all this? Curring functions can be very useful when used with other higher order functions. Let's take the example of one of the most well-known higher order functions called map function. Map is usually used to apply some operation to every element of an array or list without using a for loop. For example, if you want to double every number in a list and return it as a new list, you can use map function. In Python, you would simply take the map function, use the double function that we just created as the first argument, and the list of numbers that you want to double as the second argument, and voila, it's done. But what we did just now can be done without using curring functions as well. But where curring starts to shine is when you have to double in one situation and triple in another. Being able to partially apply multiplication really helps there. Now I'm not saying that you should use curring all the time, but curring can be one of the many tools in your arsenal as a programmer, just like list comprehension or lambda functions. Now this multiplication example might make you think that computers are very good at math. In reality, computers suck at math. If you want to know why, watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.